Get ready to match the stars. Don Galloway, Brett Summers, Charles Nelson Reilly. From The Price is Right, Ollie Hallstrom. From Vegas, Bart Braverman. And from Broadway, Fanny Flay. As we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game. And now, here's the star of Match Game, Gene Reagan.
Is that you?
Where did you get that?
I didn't do anything.
Where did
you? I was just in love with that girl back there. You hurt her.
I hope so.
She was awful thin.
Where did you get that god awful ugly thing?
She just walked up there, that's all.
Small restaurant in Texas.
Why don't you like that?
Did you look at it?
Yes. It's you. It's the real you, Holly.
No, I didn't.
Stand up there. Spread your arms like that.
Gene, would you like me to suggest what you can do?
No, Gene, you know I'm just kidding. I'm only saying that because I want to get back on this show, really. But, no, that's an awful thing. Who gave you that?
Oh, we had a little conspiracy going here. No, the thing just walked up backstage, and I said, "Why don't you join me on camera?" And she said, "Sure." Well, hello there, Shelley. I remember you. Where are you going?
I didn't tell her to go anywhere. I don't know where she... I didn't tell her to go anywhere, and I don't know why she's going there.
All right, Johnny, you want to play Holly Hallstrom's part? There it is. You broke her fingers. You've been crying, haven't you?
Crying.
Bearded Holly Hallstrom.
The real name.
All right, let's have Shelley Lewis step down here on the little blue dot and have a go at the Big Money Super Match here. But before we do that, would you just, for those who might not have been tuned in last time we were together, quickly review the facts of your life?
My name is Shelley Lewis, home's Allenhurst, New Jersey, and I peddle space. I sell advertising space here in Los Angeles.
All right, and you're living here full time now?
Yes.
Yes. All right. Here we go, Shelley. We polled the studio audience not too long ago, and we said, write down your best answer to this. We're having a blank. Now, if you give us the answer that that studio audience wrote down most frequently, we'll give you $500. For matching the second most popular answer, $250. And for matching the third, $100. Now, three of the six stars are allowed to suggest answers and give you a little help here.
Okay, Bart?
We're having a ball.
Really? All right.
Holly?
We're having a party.
We're having a party.
Charles?
We're having a fight.
So we're having a fight, we're having a ball, we're having a party. Do you want one of those or one of your own?
I'm going to go with that. We're having a ball.
We're having a ball. That's Bart's answer, right? We're having a ball. Let's find out if we have one up there somewhere. May we see the $100 response. What?
We're having
a baby.
That's what happens after you do the first two.
After you do the first two, then you have a baby. Go to a party, you have a ball, then you have a baby, then you have a fight. Yeah. All right, let's take a look at the next one, please. Having a party, that's up there. They give you that. That's Holly's answer. Last chance now. Here we go. Aha! Well, you got it. Good for you. You like that?
Yeah.
Can I try it?
Yeah.
Sure, come on over here.
No. All right, you got $500, means at least you'll play for 10 times that amount, or $5,000. But there's a catch to it. You have to spin the wheel. Double or nothing. No, I'm only kidding. It can be $5,000 or $10,000 for you. Give it a spin. Doesn't have to be too violent a spin. Must make one revolution. Here we go. Fanny.
It's Fanny double.
You got it. Well done. What a good spinner she is. She did it. All right, on the blue dot facing me. Over here, that's it. $10,000. Ready? Here it is. Isn't it blank? Isn't it blank? Fanny's made up her mind. Now, if you match her, you get $10,000. How do you fill in that blank?
Isn't it a shame?
Isn't it a shame? That's one guy thinks you're right. I see, with one person is clapping there. Apparently, you don't agree with that, do you, audience? What would you say? Isn't it romantic? That's another good one. Fanny, she says, isn't it a shame? That's her answer.
I'm so sorry. I was a song. Isn't it a lovely day?
Isn't it a lovely day? Do you know that song? To be caught in the rain and all that sort of thing? All right, now listen, Shelley, you've got $500, and we'll bring Bob Austin back here to play game number two. Okay with you? Yeah. All right, here he comes. Bob Austin. Step up here. There you go. Hello, Bob.
How are you?
All right. Now, would you let us hear the sound of your voice and refresh our memories about where you're from and what you do with your life? This audience is interested in hearing you speak.
Well, actually, it's like this. I'm sorry, I forgot myself.
Yeah.
It's just trying to raise my voice, actually. Yeah.
This is his normal, natural voice. Listen to this fella.
I'm from Houston, Texas.
Yay!
Right on.
And you're not making a fool of yourself,
an Oiler fan. And I am a bachelor father whose daughter is 12, and she's... feels that she's done a pretty good job of raising me so far. And it's the truth. You should ask her. And I'm a car salesman.
Here in the Los Angeles area somewhere.
Well, just now we moved here, and so I will be in the...
All right, sir. Good luck to both of you. We'll start game number two. This is the final game. And, Bob, this time you say A or B.
B.
B it is for you. Ready.
Ready.
Why not?
Fat Frida is so fat. She can't find a bra to fit her, so instead she wears two blanks. Now that you've disfigured this lovely creature, I'm going to have to remove her from the premises. I'll see you later.
Oh, this is so bad.
Fat Frida's so fat, Bob. She can't find a bra to fit her, so instead she wears two blanks.
Pillowcases.
Pillowcases. Okay. I must be a very strangely shaped figure, I would say. That what pillowcases look like?
Actually, I'm interested in a lot of scientific endeavors, too.
Yes.
For example... I just discovered a strain of mold that cures penicillin.
No.
I don't believe there is a really good answer for this question, and certainly this one is not
That's the perfect answer.
It is?
The perfect answer to this question.
This was the answer that probably...
Can't take it over.
Parachutes. I mean, parachutes are shaped something like them, aren't they? Well, show them what they're shaped. No, I guess you know what they're shaped like. What do you say?
With Fanny, you know.
Yes.
And I started to put a lot of garbage into an old plaster sack.
Yes.
Plastic sack, and I found out what it was. And that's what she uses, two large plastic sacks.
Two large plastic sacks.
Because I'm just a teacher from my experience.
Minus two, I would say.
Parachute.
Parachute. The excellent answer. Fat Frida's so fat, can't find a bra to fit her, so instead she wears two what, Holly?
Well, you just had me so unnerved that I just thought of the stupidest thing you could possibly say, and so I said it. Balloons.
Balloons.
I wouldn't say that.
Oh, Patsy.
Girls.
Yeah. Bart, what do you say to this?
When nothing else will hold the load, you can always count on hefty bags. Double strength, double endurance.
Yes.
Big loads they handle. Big loads.
All right, Fanny.
Well, the only thing I thought of was two deflated blimps.
Deflated blimps.
Yes.
Yes, right. Oh. All right, so, Bob, you had a tough one, and we've got one of equal difficulty for you, but first we have this for you. Here we go. Shelley, you're round one question. Dumb Dora is so dumb... when she didn't have any mothballs, she packed her sweaters in blank balls. All right, cut the music. Dumb Dora is so dumb, Shelley. When she didn't have any mothballs, she packed her sweaters in blank balls.
Golf balls.
Golf balls. All right. There are all kinds of possibilities here, aren't there? Golf balls is one.
As it happens, I selected one of the other possibilities.
Basketball's another one. Anything here. What do you say?
Did she say golf?
She said golf.
So did I.
You did. One for her. What do you say?
A check shows golf balls.
Oh, that's two for her. First thought that came to my mind was tennis balls. What'd you say, Holly?
Malted milk balls.
Malted milk balls. They're delicious. They were, and the moths could eat those instead of the wool, couldn't they?
I tried to follow the line of the general line of thought of moth, and I went for butterfly balls.
Oh.
Well, small but effective.
Right. All right. What do you say?
I said golf balls.
All right. Unusual for the first round to pick up three, isn't it? So, since you're ahead, Shelley, you'll have to go first.
A, please.
Three people play. Don, Holly, and Bart.
Moyes.
Gloria said, I just bought a genuine human hair blonde wig for $5. And now I know why it was so cheap. My new blonde wig has blank. It's a neat printer. Shelley, Gloria said I just bought a genuine human hair blonde wig for $5, and now I know why it was so cheap. My new blonde wig has blank.
Lice.
Lice?
Lice.
Oh. Boil lice or flied lice?
Lice.
Lice, she said. What'd you say?
That's a lice answer.
I'm so ashamed of
you. She went a little crazier. I just thought dandruff.
Dandruff is a good answer. Dandruff. Yes, ma'am, Holly.
Well, I thought of dandruff, too, so I went with lice.
All right. Okay.
I personally stayed with dandruff, I thought.
Dandruff. So, we pick up one there, and now, Bob Austin, here's the way it is. You need four to tie and five to win.
All right.
Okay, Robert.
Ugly Ulfria is so ugly. Good for you. So ugly, for her, a blank is a beauty mark. That's ugly. This is an easy one now. All ready over there? Over here, Bob Austin. Ugly Ulfria is so ugly, for her, a blank is a beauty mark.
A pimple.
A pimple. All right. Don, show us your pimple.
I think this, I hope that's a match.
A boil.
That's
a pimple.
A pimple isn't a boil?
It's a pimple to the extreme.
Not a boil. A boil was an enormous pimple. No?
Yeah. Yes.
I'm not going to be able to talk him into it. I don't
Before
think.
It breaks open, it is a pimple. Before we lance it, it's a simple little pimple there.
Look at it.
All right.
Wart.
Wart. Now, you have to match the whole bottom tier to achieve a tie here. No, and Charles to stay
I'm
in the game.
Sorry, Wart.
Wart. All right. So that what means Shelley wins the game. What the rest of you have here?
What did you say?
Pimple, Wart.
Well, Bob Austin, it was a pleasure to meet a guy like you. We got some gifts. We're going to send you a 1974 telephone book. You're going to love it.
Thank you.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye. Bye-bye. Here's a little message for you. Shelley Lewis, up here for the second time. How you feel?
Good. Real good.
You feel good about this one? All right, I hope you win it. Let's find out what happens here now, Shelley. We polled the studio audience. not too long ago. Average group, good group like these. And we said, write down your best answer to this. Blank for my baby. Remember, if you give us the answer that they wrote down most frequently, we give you $500. If you match their second most popular answer, in the middle there, you'll get $250. And then for matching the third, you'll get $100. Now, let's step out here and see who you want to call on. Three out of the six are able to help.
Franny.
And her sister Fanny.
Fanny?
Yes.
Wait a minute. I know there's a good one. One for my baby.
One for my baby?
Yeah.
And one for more for the road. Song?
Bart.
Oh, that was mine. One for my baby. For my baby. Just for my baby.
Just for my baby.
Oh, this, you scum. One for my baby's the answer.
All right, one more.
Holly.
They're all avoiding your gaze.
I wish you wouldn't have done
this
that.
This is a hard one.
It's like blank. You know, it's like, wow, it's like really blank up here, you know? It's like candy.
Candy for my baby?
Candy for my baby, I guess.
All right, candy for my baby, one for my baby, and just for my baby. Those are the three they've given you. You can choose one of those or give us one of your own. What is your pleasure?
One for my baby.
One for my baby. You couldn't think of anything else?
Pray for my baby.
What's that?
Pray for my baby, but...
Pray for my baby.
Yeah.
You think one for my baby would be more popular? All right. One for my baby. Let's find out if it's up there. And if so, where? Here we go with a $100 response. Candy for my baby is what Holly said. That's there. All right, let's take a look at the next one, please. Kisses for my baby. What is that?
Sweet and adorable answer if I ever saw one.
Kisses Nothing. For my baby.
Held over from the chocolate-covered woman.
Right. We're looking one for my baby. Let's slide the big one. You got it. Yeah. Fanny gave it to you. All right. Well, Shelley, that's $500. What'd she win in the previous one? $500. So now... $1,000 is yours irrevocably. That's, you can go home with that. Or at least it'll come to you in the mail in 3 or 4 years. But the mails are slow these days, you know. Our check writer is very slow. But this means that you're going to play again for $5,000. And again, you're going to spin the wheel. You remember what you did last time?
Yes, it doubles.
You doubled. It landed on a star. Let's see if you can do it again. Can she do it again?
Yeah.
I ask you. Yes. Sure she can. There it goes.
You can do it. You can do it. Come on, babe. You can do it, sweetheart. I know you can. Get that.
You got it, John.
You got it, Don. Donnie, it's y'all. Oh, no, it's Fanny.
Come on.
Oh, it is a close one. It can't get any closer without being on there. Well, you're playing for $5,000, a goodly sum, my dear. Step down here, and let's have a go at it. Is that a goodly sum?
Yes, it certainly is.
To me, is it a goodly sum?
It certainly is.
Yes. All right. Stand right there. Face me. Take a deep breath. No, don't do that. It excites me. All right, let's see what we have here.
Read the question.
You ready, Franny? Yes. Blank moments. Blank moments.
Oh, it's time for my pill.
What did she say?
She's trying to give you her best effort, and she thought it over very carefully. She's decided what her answer is. Now you have to decide what yours is to match her. What do you say?
Special moments.
Special moments. All right, Fanny, she says special moments will do it. What do you say?
I never had it. I'm sorry. I had magic moments.
Magic moments.
Oh.
Great moments is what I thought
magic
of.
Magic moments are special.
Magic moments
Too
are
many
special moments. Yeah, but here it has to be an exact match to collect all
I'm
the money.
Sorry.
Well, Shelley Lewis has $1,000, and we're very happy about that. Now we've got this message for you. Gene Rayburn here. Don't forget to see Bart Braver. The movie is called...
The movie's called Alligator, the Story of a Lonely Reptile in the Sewer.
All right. We'll look for that. Thank you all. You were just splendid. Gene Rayburn, join us next time for the Match Game. Goodbye.
Some of our contestants will receive Be everything you can be with Mary Kay Cosmetics. Skin care and glamour cosmetics presented to you in your home by trained beauty consultants, Mary Kay Cosmetics. And Garanimals, separate tops and bottoms for kids that coordinate by matching animal tags. Garanimals, top value at terrific prices. Quality never looked better. And two towels and Capri foaming bath oil provides a relaxing bouquet for your bath, leaving your skin soft and smooth, your bathtub clean. Capri, more of a beautiful thing for less. And a walk and La Choy Chinese food. Let your meal swing American with La Choy bean sprouts, vegetables, water chestnuts, bamboo shoots, and soy sauce. And a Betty Crocker cookbook can make someone happy with creamy deluxe frosting. Taste buttercream creamy, spreads buttercream creamy. Try creamy deluxe to buttercream creamy frosting. And a serve, add, and pledge. Gives your furniture a clean, clear, more beautiful shine. Pledge brings out the beauty every time you dust. And from Blue Luster Home Care Products, Blue Luster Dry, the new upholstery cleaner for velvets and other delicate furniture fibers. And Bill Totman production. Program was edited for broadcast.